Hi, I'm Tracy Cardwell from LPCiminelli and the host of the Buffalo Public Schools renovation program, Making It Happen. The Making It Happen show is a monthly news show that brings the community information about the renovated schools, along with opportunities for our minority and women business enterprises and opportunities for our Buffalo Public School students. LPCiminelli is the program manager for the renovation program, and they are also the producers of the Making It Happen show. Okay, well right now we're at Bennett High School and starting to take place. You can see right behind me, students are lining up for the 4th annual College Career and Scholarship Fair. We are so excited because it's been many months in preparation, and you may not be aware, but this was the vision of our former superintendent, Dr. James A. Williams. And we're just so proud to see that the district continued this practice, because we understand how important it is for our students to learn about the opportunities as it relates to scholarships and higher education. So a little later on, we're going to go around and talk to some of our presenters. We have over 15 workshops that will be presented to our students, and we also have over 50 exhibitors that's just waiting to greet all of our students. But first, we're going to go over to McKinley High School, where the Mission Control is taking place again. Our very own project manager, Vinny Jowdy, he has a special guest speaker, Gaelle Berges from Vegetal I.D. She gives a great presentation about her green roofs. So I can't wait for you to see that. Thank you so much for tuning in, but don't go away. We'll be right back.
Thank you for coming. This is for the building trades kids. This is our 20th, we call it Mission Control. It's a kind of a program we've been running since we started the reconstruction here that gives you kids an opportunity to see our industry, what we're doing at your school. We started out basically when we started digging into the ground. We had an opportunity to take the ecology and horticulture programs around when you came back to school this year. Gives you an opportunity to see what we do. Maybe it helps you with some of your career decisions. And today, we have Gaelle Berges, who's with a company called Vegetal I.D. They're headquartered in France. They have an office in Batavia, and their specialty is green roofs. So if you remember in this school, above the new main office, it's a single story space, there's gonna be a green roof on that roof there, okay? In the courtyard, under the ground, we've got a 3,000-gallon retention system. So when it rains, the water that doesn't percolate into the plants runs off. We collect the water in the retention system. We can filter it, pump it to the greenhouse, irrigate the plants. Anything that's not used is then basically gravity fed out towards your parking lot on the north side of the building near the cafeteria. And underground there are big 4-foot diameter pipes that store the water, let it filter out through a manhole that's out there, and then it drains across your football field underground to Skedaddle Creek. It's all part of this whole process of design that's here at your school, so it's kind of neat.
So today we're going to talk about green roofs. Here's some pictures of, what does it look like. It's pretty much plants on top of a roof. And this is a whole neighborhood that has been done in France. It looks neat. You can understand that it's beautiful, but really, why would we install a green roof? Do you have any suggestion why we would,
Keeps it cooler.
Sorry? Yeah, keeps cooler. Exactly, the building will be cooler because the insulation is better. Yeah, exactly. So the plants will absorb water, and instead of releasing it, on the black roof, it will just go away like that. You absorb the water. So the main benefits are, as you said, stormwater management. It cleans the air. It cools down the cities, and it brings some biodiversity and wildlife onto our roofs. It's not grass that we're putting. Here is something that I want you to see. Those are the plants that we're using on the green roof. They're called sedums. All right. Okay, I pass it around, sorry. So those plants are sedum. They will flower once, twice a year. They will make beautiful, you know, pink, yellow, red flowers. And the bees really love them. They make a lot of honey out of it. We can indeed put vegetables on a roof too, but the soil will have to be deeper. And what would be the problem if you have a really deep green roof? Exactly, it will be really heavy. So we're trying to, you know, balance, make it a lightweight green roof and efficient for stormwater and stuff. So those rocks are really light, and it's because they're made like popcorns are made. So they're heat in a big oven, and they explode to be really light and porous. And it's how we can manage to have really light green roofs. Yeah, we can. So, for example, if you want, you know, to convince your parents to do it, you will have to have an engineer to see how much weight the roof can support. And then we'll do, you know, a company like us or other companies will just study how to make it, you know, on a steep roof. So, how long does last a normal roof? Do you know?
2 years.
A lot less.
Last 20. It depends on the shingle type.
Exactly. It's supposedly 15 to 20 years, a normal roof. A green roof, we can expect it to last at least 60 years.
60.
So you will save a lot of money on the long run. So it's not grass, as you said, as you saw, it's sedums, and they will grow as high as this. This is the highest. So you don't come to mow, like you won't. You will have only for the maintenance. You will just have to come to weed, take off the bad plants, and fertilize once a year. And that's pretty much it.
LPCiminelli and Marnetta Malcolm invite you to an evening of elegance and entertainment. Black Tie for Black History Extravaganza is an event that celebrates the difference makers in our community. This year's event will be held Friday, February 24th from 7 to 10 p.m. at the Trough Music Hall located at 622 Main Street. This year we will honor Satoria and Kevin Donovan, Miss Eva Doyle, Mr. George Johnson, Dr. Lavon Ansari, Ellicott District Council Member Reverend Darius Pridgen, Maston District Council Member Damone Smith, Mr. Terrence McAlvey, and Mrs. Deatra Trueheart. The event is hosted by Marnetta Malcolm, and LPCiminelli is proud to be the major sponsor. For more information, please call 544-8080. Hope to see you there.
I want to say good morning on behalf of the Buffalo Public Schools, and thank you for coming out to our annual scholarship fair.
Okay, we are back, and I'm standing next to Superintendent Amber Dixon. We are at the fourth annual College Career and Scholarship Fair at Bennett High School. We just had our welcoming orientation to our students. Amber, this is a great event. Great morning. Not so nice outside, but it's okay, right?
It's fine. What matters is what's happening inside our walls today.
Absolutely.
We have almost 500 students registered to come and figure out how to get to the future they're dreaming for themselves. We have community partners. We have have business partners, we have college partners, we have more adults in this community coming forward today to make sure that these students, our Buffalo children, get to college, get into the careers they want, and help us build a future for themselves and us as well.
Absolutely. Now you touched on some really great points during your opening speech regarding students staying in Buffalo.
Well, you know, I'm a parent of a student who left Buffalo, and I know I speak for a lot of the parents. We need our young people to find careers and futures right here in this city. Buffalo needs a reinvigoration. We have wonderful opportunities in the medical corridor. We have a community that's ready to rebuild itself, but we need these young people to go to college, get training in a career, and come back and live in these cities so that we can have our grandchildren nearby.
I agree. I agree 100%. Absolutely. I want to thank you for your support. Thank you so much for supporting this effort, you know, and just really encouraging the business partners, everybody, all the partners, all the collaborations, and the students.
Well, of all our collaborations, I have to say our work with Siminelli has really been significant. We've known through this whole event that you were right here by our side, so I want to thank you as well. You're building our future in more ways than one.
Oh my goodness, thank you so much. Amber, we'll be around.
Okay.
And I know you will too.
I will as well.
Okay, thank you. We'll be right back. All right, guys, we're back, and I'm standing next to one of my favorite people, my most favorite people, Miss Jerry Horton. Now, she's one of my most favorite people simply because she's just so special and so great, but also because last year for the college career and scholarship fair, we were at her school where she was the principal at East High School, and now she is the supervising principal for the Buffalo Public Schools. Also, I mean, very instrumental in our steering committee for the scholarship fair. I mean, very, very instrumental. Jerry, thank you so much for all of your support, all of your hard work to ensuring that this year has been as successful as in years past.
Tracy, thank you so much for the work that you've done. We could not have done this without you, because you had a roadmap and a blueprint from last year. You knew where we should go and what we should do the next step. So I really appreciate the work that you've done. But we all do this for the children in the city of Buffalo and Erie County, and it's all about the children. And that's why we do what we do.
Absolutely. And you do it well.
Thank you.
I have to say it. You do it well. Why don't we just talk to the community a little bit of how important, you know, events like this, how important are they to our students, you being a principal of such a large school, East High School?
Tracy, a former principal, but I think these are so important because of the dollars that children are able to have access to. Right. Once they come into the scholarship fair, we have vendors that give out their scholarships. Our children also learn how to maneuver the financial system for colleges by being able to complete their FAFSA form, mm-hmm. and knowing what dollars they will have access to. And with the scholarships that are available to them, maybe some students wouldn't know it or wouldn't get that scholarship application, but they're all right here. They can go see all of our vendors, get those applications, know the deadline date, all of that. So monies that may not have been accessible to our children, it is right in one room, and they have an opportunity to meet and talk to all of the sponsors of those scholarships. So it's almost like a pre-interview prior to getting that scholarship. And just writing that college application letter, that's the one thing our children may not have access to in the classroom, mm-hmm. but we have a vendor here ready to help them start to write that college essay. So it's an outstanding opportunity for our children to have access that maybe they wouldn't have in a normal day.
That's right. Now let's talk about the seminars and workshops that are taking place. We've got, you know, essay writing, tips on choosing the right colleges.
Okay, and tips on choosing careers, yep. and there's lots of things for our students to get involved in. If you're not sure of a career that you want to go to, we have lots of healthcare careers in there. We also have opportunities for students who just want to go right into a trade for work, and we have the locals that are here to say, here, you can become an apprentice. You can you don't have to always go to college. There are also other opportunities for our students, and all of that is right here today.
Oh my gosh, this is so awesome. I get excited. I really do, because there is so many opportunities for our students today.
Right, and I think we're all excited about the possibilities for our children and having the Promise community to be here to be a part and to support this, having all of our supporters, and this is the great part, is that we have people in the community that are supporting our students and supporting our school district, so it's really exciting. Every year, we're always up late at night because we want to make sure everything goes over well.
That's
and
great.
Work hard to get it all together, so this is going to be a great day.
It is. And we were here late last night, weren't we?
Yes, we were. Yes, we were, to make sure everything went off. So it's exciting today, and we're excited. And we really want to thank you, LPCiminelli, for all of the work that they've done. They've been one of our biggest supporters, and we really appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you for the support, and thank you for everything that you've done.
You're welcome, and thank you.
Okay, we'll be back. Okay, guys, right now we're standing in the exhibitors area, which is in the gymnasium at Bennett High School. Again, we're at the College Career and Scholarship Fair, and I'm standing with my peeps here. These my homies from LPCiminelli's, my girls. This is Molly, and this is Kim. We are so silly, you know, but we're having such a great time here because we love to see all of the energy that is in this room. Ladies, let's talk about the energy and what the turnout has been like so far, because I got to say, you know, winter decided to show up today with all the snow and the cold temps, but we still had a great turnout. Wouldn't you agree, Molly?
Oh, absolutely. Over 500 students have turned out today, and lots of people coming up to the booth asking questions, wanting to know about programs that we have available for the summer, and it's been a wonderful opportunity.
Absolutely. Now, Kim, now what are you telling students and parents about what we're offering here?
Well, we're talking about all of the great programs that we have, our scholarship that we offer to the BPS students. We're talking about our internship program, our Discover Design, and encouraging kids to come out for TEAM, which runs from October to June.
That's right. All right. Did you guys hear that? LPCiminelli, we are there. We are helping our students become successful, because that's what it's all about, right? We're not just building schools. We're not just renovating schools, right?
We're building communities.
Hello. Thank you, ladies, for all that you do. You guys rock. They rock, man. They rock. We'll be back. Okay, guys, we are back, and we're still in the exhibitors area, and I'm standing with some pretty awesome guys here. I feel well protected, I might add. I'm going to have them introduce themselves.
Richard Nader, I'm a training director for Local 41, the electricians.
I'm George Chalk, the training coordinator for Local 22 Plumbers and Steamfitters.
I'm Kevin Strainer, the business agent for Local 22 Plumbers and Steamfitters.
All right, guys, I want to thank you for being here, for supporting, you know, the BPS College Career and Scholarship Fair, you know, because we all know that college isn't for everyone, right? It's not for everyone, and there's other opportunities, and we're talking about the locals, the unions, okay? Let's talk about that, Richard.
Sure. We have two apprenticeship opportunities available, residential and inside. Our residential program's 3 years in length, 4,800 hours of on-the-job training, 3 years of classroom-related training. Our inside program, very vigorous program, it's 5 years in length, 8,200 hours of on-the-job training, 5 years of classroom-related training at 208 hours per year. They're both great programs, great pay, great benefits, four pensions, three of them are defined benefit pensions, the other one is a defined contribution pension. At the end of your career, you're leaving the trade very comfortable.
That's right, that's right. How important is it for you to be here today, George?
Well, we look for all these individuals that aren't really set out for college, and the trades are where they should be. Like Dick, our program is a five-year program. We do 216 hours of instructional training a year. We take on an average of about 30 apprentices a year, 15 steam fitters, 15 plumbers, and ultimately, our education is paid for. They come out of it with no debt. I think it's a great opportunity for those who are great with their hands.
Yeah.
I think when they get out, they're making well over what some college kids make when they get out of their career. So I think it's a great opportunity, and we have many, many applicants, young and old, and we take a whole slew of different people, and we look forward to the opportunity to teach people our trade. And with the way the trades are right now, the shortage of union trade or just trade related people, welders are in great demand throughout the country. We hear that day in, day out, and hopefully this is an opportunity for people to get into the trade.
Yeah, I totally, totally agree. Richard, I want to thank you for your support, because you are also a member of the steering committee for this scholarship fair. How many years have you been involved with it?
4 years.
Yes, 4 years. So I want to thank you for your continued support because you understand the importance.
Absolutely. You're very welcome.
Yes. And so, you know what? We're going to take a look. We're going to go to a couple of workshops. I know you have an apprenticeship workshop that's going on, right? And you have...
I've got three female apprentices that are running that for me. Actually, the one just finished up her hours. She's a journey worker. And they're just letting everybody in there know that the opportunities are in this trade, not only for the males, but the females.
And what school are they graduates from?
We've got two that are graduates from the Buffalo Public Schools, Hutch Tech.
That's what I wanted to hear. Yep. We're proud of all of our students, though. We really are. We're proud of all of them. But thank you again, guys.
You're welcome. Thank you so much.
And we'll see you next year, right?
Yes. You bet.
All right, great. All right, we'll be right back. All right, guys, I'm back, and I'm standing with my other buddy here. He's my buddy. He's a great guy. Mr. Ambrose Price II. Ambrose, he's the overseer of College Goal New York, which is a program that helps students fill out their FAFSA, financial aid, and TAP forms. I mean, this is like the driving force of the scholarship fair. And Ambrose, I can't thank you enough, you know, for the support that you've given, you know, Buffalo Public Schools, LPCiminelli, all of the partners, you know, the support that you've given our students overall.
Well, you're a great guy. Tracy, look, thanks to LPCiminelli and the support that you've given us over the years. It's been fabulous working with you. I mean, this program is great. We've seen it grow over the years. The first year we did this, we had 9 people.
Wow.
We had 9 students. We had 35 volunteers. So we've flipped that a little bit. We always get great financial aid support from the community.
Let's talk about these volunteers. Now, that's okay. The one thing. Now, I've interviewed so many people today, but we never talked about the volunteers, and okay. That is okay. Instrumental.
Absolutely.
Let's talk about them.
All right. We get volunteers from all the colleges and universities here locally. This year, we had a little bit of a conflict with SUNY Day, so the UB and some of the Buff states had split off their duties.
Okay.
But, I mean, we've got all the private schools here. We've got ITT here. We've got Trocare here, Canisius College. We even got Fredonia that came up.
Yes.
And we actually got a couple folks from Syracuse this year to help us out, to help with the support. But new experienced financial aid officers, novice financial aid officers, they're all here banding together to get the job done. So it's super.
What's the turnout been as far as the students? Because we talked about the weather, you know, winter decided to show up today.
I don't know the exact numbers yet, but it has been a constant flow. We broke them out into like 50 per hour sessions.
Mm-hmm.
It's been a steady stream. The computers have always been busy. We have 57 terminals, so I think we're doing pretty good. We'll get a final count a little bit later.
That's awesome.
Yep.
That's great.
It's been great working with you on this as well. You know, year after year, we've been able to put it together. And thanks LPCiminelli for all your support.
And thank you to you.
All right.
We look forward to next year.
Let's do it again.
And the year after that.
Oh,
because as long as the students need us, we'll be here, right?
Absolutely.
Because that's what's important.
As long as they need us, we'll be here for them. All right.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks, Tracy.
We'll be right back. Okay, guys, we're back, and we're still in the exhibitors room, and I'm standing with another student here. We have Mr. Derek. Derek, what's your last name again?
Moody. Derek Moody.
Hey, Derek. Okay, what are you, a senior?
Yeah, I'm a senior at McKinley High School.
Okay, and what are you doing at McKinley? I'm holding you close because I want you to stay close so the community can see you, okay?
All right.
What are you doing over at McKinley?
I'm in the carpentry program. We're currently building a house in our school, and it's for Habitat for Humanity.
That's what I like to hear. Now I gotta ask you another question. Are you involved with the mission control that we're doing over there with Vinny Jowdy?
Yes, I believe so.
Good answer. Do you know what mission control is?
Not really, but.
All right, who's your teacher, Mr. Fazone?
Mr. Stabell.
Stabell?
Yeah.
So you have, okay, now the mission control is when he takes you out once a month and go to the project?
Yes.
All right.
We call it shadowing, but.
Shadowing.
I'll take it.
All right. Now, on to something else. What brings you here today?
I'm here to, you know, search for scholarship programs, you know, check out new colleges, you know, a lot of opportunities here. It's a good thing.
Yeah, it is a good thing. Where do you see yourself after high school? Where do you want to go?
Any good college, you know. I could go to college, you know, for building trades or, you know, sometimes I'm undecided. You never know. I might switch up a career, so.
And there's nothing wrong with that. And I know people told you that, right?
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with that. I mean, because you're still young and it's still early enough for you to make that decision.
Mm-hmm.
But the most important part is that you're here today.
Yep.
You're here today and you are taking advantage of all the tools that are here to help you for after graduation. Have you applied to any colleges yet?
I applied to Alfred State.
Okay.
Fredonia.
That's a great college.
Both State.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah, okay. So I know you'll hear something back from them soon.
Yep.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What workshops did you go to so far?
I went to Madai.
Okay.
NCCC.
Okay. Now when I say workshops, I'm talking about the workshops that we have going on outside of the exhibitors room. Tips on choosing the right college, career explorations, writing an essay.
I didn't go in those rooms yet. I didn't go in there yet.
There's still time.
I spent my time in here, you know, looking at all these colleges, you know, trying to get more information.
Okay, but you know what?
I'll check it out, though. I'll definitely
check
it out.
You better.
Yeah.
Because there's some good information in there. And I know you're a good kid, but I know you'll do well. I know you will. Okay? And I wish you all the best of luck.
Yep.
Okay?
Yep.
All right. We'll be right back.
Good seeing you. Good.
Okay, we're back now, and I'm standing with another student who's here at the College Career and Scholarship Fair. This is Alex. He is a junior at Hutch Tech. He's also a team member, LPCiminelli Construction Connections team member. So, Alex, it's good to see you here today. What brings you out today?
I just wanted to take in a lot of information about all the colleges. I hadn't quite figured out which college I wanted to go to, so I figured it'd be good to learn more about it. And also, I figured it was a great opportunity to get scholarships and learn about apprenticeships over.
You know what? That's it in a nutshell. This is why it's so great that you're here this year, your junior year, so that when you go into your senior year, you're so ahead of the game because you've got all the information. Have you visited any of our workshops?
Yeah, actually, I visited like all of them, I think.
You did? You went to all the workshops?
Yeah.
Okay, that's even better. So then next year, like I said, when you come back, you'll be able to do your FAFSA, fill out your financial aid form for free, and your TAP form for free, but you'll know about all of this, right?
Yeah.
Okay, what do you have in mind as far as, you know, what you want to go into?
Well, I figure some sort of engineering. I really like electrical.
Yeah.
I like to help people.
Okay.
Save money.
Okay.
It's a good idea. It's like a good field to go into.
Before you leave, make sure you go talk to Richard Nader. He's over at IBEW, Local 41. Okay, that's the electrical workers. Did you see him yet already?
Yeah, I actually talked to him.
Oh, good. He's a good person to talk to. Get in his corner. He's got apprenticeships and all that great stuff for you. So you're in the right place, buddy. You're in the right place. But I knew that because you're a team member. Good things are going to happen to you, Alex.
Yeah.
I guarantee
it. I hope so.
It will. It will. All right. We'll be right back. Hey guys, that concludes our show for today. Thank you so much for tuning in. As you can see, we're still at the exhibitors area at the scholarship fair. Things are just wrapping up. It was an awesome event. Lots of energy, lots of opportunities for our students. So again, I'm very pleased to say it was another successful year for our scholarship fair. Don't forget, we are on YouTube. Go to YouTube, type in LP Simonelli's Making It Happen. There you'll be able to view all of our past and current shows. All of my Facebook friends, don't forget to, you know, check our Facebook page, the LP Simonelli's Making It Happen page, for any upcoming opportunities or events. Don't forget, we have our Making It Happen hotline. You know the number is right there below it. Call us with any questions, comments, or suggestions. Thanks so much for tuning in, and until next time, let's keep making it happen. We'll be right back.